one of the benefits of waking up at this time is you get to see the sunrise. Look at that. It's beautiful.
Happy St. Patrick's Day and welcome to the first day of the peak. So it is Sunday morning, 7 a.m. Got my morning routine out of the way. And over the course of the next 5 weeks, I am going to be doing my best to upload onto this pretty much every day, which is gonna be challenging. But you know, I want to document the process because it's gonna be a little bit different to any of the other peaks I've done for powerlifting. So this is my last Sunday in this office. My last Sunday in my lovely office. These things make the room look extremely messy. I really like the office, but you know what? We're gonna be leaving. Because we're moving out of this house, apartment. I've been calling it apartment, it's a house. We're moving out of this apartment on Friday. We're going to be staying in an Airbnb not too far away as we move everything out of the place. And then the following Thursday, we're moving to Spain. So yeah, moving country in the middle of a powerlifting peak. Then after I move to Spain, I'm going to be there for like a week and then I'm going home to finish off the prep. So it's going to be a pretty manic few weeks. So I want to kind of bring you through the process because, to be honest, I'm going to like, at the moment, I'm certainly not stressed about it. I'm pretty calm about it. Like, it's just moving country, whatever. Anyway, today's Sunday. Today's the first day of the peak. I'm going to show you what the actual training session of today is going to look like, and you know what is on the like what's on the cards for today. So this is the RTS track system. This is where I track all of my training, and this is where John writes me in my program. So just gonna click on the program here. And now, this essentially is what we have to work with for the peak. So today, Sunday of course, we have our squats with our knee wraps, we have our bench, and then some accessories. Thankfully, I'm not doing the SPD sessions anymore because They were very, very tough. They were extremely long as well. So gonna be doing my regular squat today. Okay, as usual, I always do my squats on Sundays. We're gonna be working up to top single. So it's gonna be interesting because I finished off the last block on a nice PB. Then we're gonna do a top triple. Then we're gonna do two back offs. Similar kind of idea with the bench press here. Gonna be doing a top single, the top triple, and then my main deadlift day, which is going to be very interesting, I am going to be just doing triples. Okay, going to be doing ramping sets up to an 8, and this is going to be the first time that I have not done top singles on deadlift to peak, so I'm really interested to see how this goes. It'll definitely keep me mindful of the intensities that I'm using, and using ramping sets does give you a little bit of opportunity, like better opportunity to kind of gauge RPE. It's harder to overshoot on triples. And one thing that I want to be super mindful of during this peak is overshooting, right? Overshooting during a regular training block, you know, it might happen. It does happen, to be fair, to me a little bit. I like to get after it, you know. Personally, I'm like, oh, I'd rather push the limit than under push, but it's not necessarily the best thing for strength. But during this peaking phase, with the high intensities, with the top singles, with the triples, you know, if I am overshooting, overextending myself in my training sessions, it's harder for that fatigue to dissipate. So it's really, really important now over the next few weeks to pace myself. So with that, I have kind of thought into the future. I'm thinking into the future as to where I want to be in 5 weeks' time. And I'm pacing myself. And this is one thing that I will mention to my clients if they are struggling with like overshooting, is to start your block with the end in mind. So think about where you want to be in a few weeks' time and then kind of backtrace your steps. Now, obviously, if you're using a fixed RPE system, you know, you do have to allow for some of the days where you need to auto-regulate based off how your stress levels are going to be, and definitely going to be something you're going to have to pay attention to as I'm moving country. And changing time zones, that's going to be a nightmare. But if you can start with that in mind, it just means then at the very start of the block, you're going to be conservative enough with the kind of load selections. And you're going to be, again, pacing yourself well throughout the block. Because like that's one thing I struggled with massively when I started using this fixed RPE system, was starting the block far too heavy. Because if you know, you see triple at an eight and you start off the training block, like your triple at an eight at the end of a training block is going to be completely different to what it is at the start, right? Because you're not necessarily detrained, but you're going to be stronger at the end of the block versus the starting block, right? So you need to kind of keep that in consideration, because at the end of the block you're peaked, at the starting block you're not. So yeah, right. So this morning, what I'm doing, I was meant to have a call with my business mentor, but we're rescheduling to tomorrow. So I'll tell you about the kind of takeaways of that call tomorrow. That's a good topic for tomorrow's conversation. But right now, I'm gonna do some work. Morning routine out of the way. I usually start the day with about 30 minutes of reading, just like different books, mindset books. Just they're interesting. I like kind of reading that type of stuff in the morning. Kind of sets me up for good, in a good headspace for to start the day. And now I've got a client program to update. He just finished a block, so I'm going to review his training and then write out his next block. And then I have to edit some podcasts. So yeah, Paddy's day is slightly different. Paddy's day used to involve me either waking up with a massive headache or still being awake because I'm out for the night before. How times have changed. Anyway.
So this is the current state today, starting off the peak. What I'll do is every day I'll post up this and kind of show you how this is changing as I get more fatigued and whatever. But yeah, at the moment I only have a little bit of soreness from the final day of the pivot. Focal tightness elsewhere. Feeling quite rested, no fatigue. I want to train. That rarely ever changes. I very rarely put in, like, I don't want to train. And I always put in normal training load as opposed to putting in other options here. Heavy load, low training load, high training load. If I put in normal training load in the same mindset as Ronnie Coleman, it's always lightweight, baby. Now, just before I get into my program updates, this is how I get through doing programming. I'm doing programming, obviously I do enjoy it, but when I just have to listen to my own thoughts doing it, it's doing those type of tasks is a little bit harder. So I typically will listen to tunes. So I am a massive fan of the Essential Mix, always have been. But this dude, he has all of the Essential Mixes from every year in a playlist. So I'm just making my way through this. One that I'm going to listen to this morning. Again, I've listened to this maybe 3 times. Lauren Low Sung. Would recommend, hit me up if you want the link to this. Or you could just search this guy on SoundCloud.
Where will we be in 2 weeks' time?
Spain.
Canada is nice when it is sunny, but that's a rarity. So it is around 9:30 now, just after 9:30. Out for a morning stroll before we go to the gym. So we have a pretty long morning before we even eat. You could say we do intermittent fasting, and we don't shite on about it like other people do. Literally just delaying a meal, like. Anyway,
not much longer on this walk. One of the reasons, I suppose, that we don't really like where we are is because of this walk, because we do walks like one or two a day, and this walk is just, it's pretty miserable. Just around a housing estate, essentially, in the main road. Not very entertaining, so. Her new place is gonna be like 50 meters from the beach. It's gonna be amazing. Anyway, we're gonna talk to each other now as opposed to talking to the camera.
I did a very bad job of spreading this one today. Some chocolate milk on the side because I forgot my 7 a.m. shake, which I usually have in my Sunday squat sessions. Let's get it in.
Hopefully you can hear me. I'm gonna have this plugged in. I got that plugged in the right track. All right, so sleeved warm-ups are out of the way. And now I'm gonna work up to my top single. So I'm gonna throw on the wraps. Starting off at 220. Had to work up to around 265 to 267. We'll see how they feel, but I'm feeling confident. This is my first time doing the singles without doing like the ramp up working sets. So I'll be interested to see what I hit when I'm fresh. All right, I'm not gonna record me doing my reps here because I need to start concentrating. All right. Yeah. Move, good.
Yeah,
good. Come on, Shane. Thank you. Yeah, go for it. Thanks so much.
As a producer, he's collaborated with Carl Cox and Oliver Heldens and remixed Mouthpiece.
There's nobody in the gym now telling me he's mono. I'm waiting for one of the new members to come. He said he would be here because I'm just about to go for my top single. And I've got sets to do after that, so what can you do? What can you do? The on button.
Okay, yeah. I will do that for you. Easy. Come on, let's go. Nice. Up on your right.
Oh, thank you.
You're very welcome.
They're tough, but manageable.
I mean, they look fast as shit.
Yeah, it's just in the bottom, like all you can think about is just like your knees, like. It's not that it's sore, it's just that it feels wrong. It's going for three. Yeah. I did lower this down a little bit now, so we'll see if.
Yeah, it's this side.
Yeah, I just feel like I'm not getting as like tight or something or wedged.
Okay.
That's good.
Come on. Easy. Yep. Up. Come on, Tim.
I got it. Yeah. All right. So that is squats done, out of the way. Eventually, an hour and a half later. Tell you what, they were different today. I definitely think so. It's been 2 weeks since I've had the wraps on. I definitely do kind of notice the difference. I hit 235 in sleeves there during the week for a triple. It was on the plan, so that's what I did. So maybe feeling a little bit rusty from that, but also just the first time doing singles on wraps. And yeah, look, I think they went okay, you know. Definitely room to move from here for sure. If that was a kind of skill thing, why I was just feeling a little bit kind of unsteady in the hole. Bracing just felt a little bit off as well. Which, look, is what it is. We move on to next week. Anyway, now it's on to bench. And we'll see how we got here. We've got a top single to do. Finish wrapping these wraps. And we'll see you on the bench.
My bird.
All right. Ready? On you, let's go. Big push, back. Come on. Very good. So had to adjust my expectations there on bench. In the program was 162, but everything felt heavy on warm up, so on the regulation. And as well, do not overshoot in week one. So went with 155, felt all right. Is what it is. Anyway, it's a good starting place for first week. And we're gonna have these two Rice Krispie squares because it is 20-3. And then I am going to do two accessories. I'm probably gonna do dips. I'm not gonna do any leg accessories today because I've been here for almost 3 hours. So, you know, I'll leave those until Thursday when I'm doing my other squat session. Okay, let's get 10 here. Not worth grinding. Not worth grinding. Beef, broccoli, and rice. Well, actually, it's not beef, it's ground bison. 4:20. Mother God.
I'm glad that I don't compete in reps every single time because training sessions should not take up this many hours of my day. Have to eat this now. I've got some work to do. Got a client to set up, new client to set up. Just have to finish off the program and record his onboarding video. And then after that, I have to upload the podcast that we did this week with Paul Sandell onto Spotify, all that kind of stuff. It doesn't take too long, but it has to be done. I want to get out for a walk at some point as well. But look, we got to get it in.
Today's vlog might be one of the longer ones, but I wanted to kind of show you just how I go through this podcast upload process. So I will usually make the old thumbnail here. Everything is done through Riverside, so I can essentially use this like genius function that like removes all like the dead silences. To be honest, like with Paul this week, there is no dead silences at all, no awkward moments, just fucking laughs. So basically I press like this kind of magic button and it just kind of cuts out any silences, any gaps. I download it, and then once I download it, I will, yes, upload it into YouTube. And now the next process is to just get the audio out and add in the intro. Now, I script the intro. I simply will trip over my words if I don't script it. And do you want to see the funniest part?
So, this room, if you haven't noticed, has an echo. So, as opposed to bringing in like this big stand that helps the room be more soundproof, when I'm really lazy, I just get this and I put it over the microphone like this, and I just read the script. So look, you gotta do what you gotta do.
Boom. Now that is recorded.
Paul Sandell. Paul is the co-founder of the PT project with James Sutton.
High tech shit.
It's fun. Can't take myself seriously when I have this around my neck. But it's funny because I probably doesn't make a difference for most people listening to the podcast, but I feel it sounds a little bit more professional when I have the intro, and you know, just saves me being like, hey guest, can you just tell us everything that we already know about yourself, and you know, give like, you know, your little kind of bio, like where do you study, all that kind of shit. People don't like talking about themselves in that way. At least I don't. And from my experience from talking to other people in those positions, they don't like every time they get on a podcast to like just like go through their fucking life story. So when I get into the meat and potatoes, right? So yeah, now this is exporting, and now I'm just gonna upload it to Anchor, and that's fucking that. Easy money. We are almost done for the day. I'm just about to record an onboarding video for a new client. So just have them all set up. And once I have them set up with like a Google Drive and the program and everything like that, I just record a video just explaining everything, just so they know exactly what I'm expecting of them. And they know exactly what to do going forward. Because communication when it comes to online coaching is extremely important, especially at the very beginning. Because it kind of sets the standard for, again, what I expect of them and what they can expect from me, most importantly. You know, if we get off to a good start with coaching, the process is very seamless. When the communication is kind of broken down at the very start, it's very hard to kind of get that going again, you know. So building relationships, true strong communication, all that kind of stuff, super important. Thankfully, I know this guy because we went to school together, so should be easy enough to coach. Anyway, I'm gonna record the onboard video and then we're gonna go for a walk.
So I think we are going to leave this vlog here for today. Since we're gonna be doing them every single day, I don't need to be showing you every single second of my day. Most of them, as you have become pretty familiar, they look pretty much the same apart from what I'm training on that day. So I'm just going to the shop now to pick up some beans for my dinner. And then after that, gonna eat my dinner, and then it's time to go to bed and edit this, of course, because we need to have to come out daily. Doggy. Anyway, hope you did enjoy the video. If you did, of course, like, share, subscribe, all that kind of stuff. I'll catch you tomorrow.